new topic, that is spectroscopy. What is spectroscopy? It is the interaction of the electromagnetic radiation with the matter. It means how the radiation interact with the matter. When electromagnetic radiation of certain frequency fall on the metal surface, the electron from a certain energy level, it absorbs the energy and it jumps to the higher energy level by absorbing this energy. As a result of this, we get an absorption spectra. And hence, this type of spectroscopy is known as the absorption spectroscopy. Now, the electron remains in this state for a certain interval. And then, it comes to its original state. And it radiates the energy. And we get the emission spectra. And this type of spectroscopy is known as the emission spectroscopy. As the electromagnetic radiations have a very broad region and it can be divided into several regions. The highest energy is of the cosmic rays, while the lowest energy region, that are the radio waves. Between these regions, there are several other types of radiations, that are microwaves, infrared, visible, UV, X-rays and gamma rays. As we know, the wavelength is the inversely proportional to the energy according to the formula E is equal to SC upon lambda. So, the wavelength increases toward this side. It means the radio waves have the highest wavelength while the cosmic rays have the lowest wavelength. So, we study the spectroscopy according to the radiations that interact with the matter. Suppose if we study the interaction of the UV radiations or the visible radiation, then it comes under the category of the UV and visible spectroscopy. And if we study the infrared radiations, then it is called the infrared spectroscopy. So in our this video, we will study about the infrared spectroscopy. What is the infrared spectroscopy? The absorption of the light in the IR region causes the transition between the vibrational and the rotational energy level. So, we get the infrared spectra, and hence this type of spectroscopy is also known as the vibrational spectroscopy. As we can see, these are two vibrational energy levels. When a compound absorbs in the IR region and when we expose it to IR radiation, a transition between these two energy levels can occur. It means the electron can jump from this to this level and a vibration transition happen. Now each vibrational energy levels are associated with several small rotational energy levels. These are the rotational energy levels. So the vibrational transition is needed. Some energy that is higher. It requires higher energy. And hence this energy is sufficient for the rotational transitions to occur. By this energy, several rotation transition can occur at the same time. And hence we also get the rotational transitions and the rotational spectra besides the vibrational spectra. So it is also known as the vibrational and rotational spectroscopy. Now what are the vibrations? As we consider a molecule, it is bond, there are bonds between the atoms, but these bonds are not rigid. These bonds are like the spring and these can move. What movements can happen? It can move toward each other or it can move far apart from each other. Such type of vibration is known as the stretching, or it can vibrate in this direction. It can do this movement. This type of movement is known as the wagging. Or it can move towards each other or apart from it. Such type of movement is known as the scissoring. Besides this, several other types of movement like bending, rocking can happen. So these are all types of the vibrations. Now the vibrational frequency of such vibrations is given by the Hooke's law, and that is nu bar is equal to 1 upon 2 pi c under root k upon mu, where nu bar is the vibrational frequency in wave numbers. It means it is equal to 1 upon lambda or the reciprocal of the wavelength. And its unit is centimeter minus 1 because it is the reciprocal of wave number, wavelength. And C is the velocity of the radiation. K is the force constant and mu is the reduced mass. That is given by mu equal to m1 into m2 upon m1 plus m2. So by this formula, we can easily calculate the vibrational frequency of any vibration. If we see the range of the IR radiation, it ranges from 12,500 to 10 centimeter minus 1, out of which the region of 4,000 to 666 centimeter minus 1 is of most importance in the organic chemistry or for the identification of the molecules, out of which the region from 4,000 to 1,300 is known as the functional group region, because most of the functional group in organic chemistry gives their peaks, gives their spectra in this region because they absorb the IR radiation in this region. So for the identification of the functional group, this region is very much important. And the region from 909 to 666 centimeter minus 1 is known as the aromatic region because the aromatic groups absorb the IR radiation in this region. While the region that is between 1300 to 909 is known as the fingerprint region because this region is a unique region for every molecule. Every molecule gives here a unique or a characteristic spectra that is not matchable from any other molecule. It is the fingerprint of that specific molecule. So this region is also known as the fingerprint region. And this region is very much complex, so you cannot study this region very easily. This region is most important for our study. The absorption of IR radiation causes the changes in the vibrational and rotational energy of the molecule, as we have said earlier. So in IR spectroscopy, only those changes are important which causes the changes in the dipole movement of molecule. It means the molecules absorbs the IR radiations only when the absorption of this radiation causes the changes in the dipole movement of the molecule. And such changes gives rise to the IR spectra. And hence, such molecules are known as the IR active molecules. For example, if we see CO2, HCl, CH3Cl or benzene, all these molecules are heteronuclear species. It means they possess different atoms. So, if they absorb the IR radiation, there will be change in their dipole movement. So, these molecules are IR active. While H2O2, N2 and such other homonuclear species, there will be no change in their dipole movement because both the atoms are same. So these species does not absorb in the IR region and these are called IR inactive. So now the point is, what is IR spectra and how it is obtained? Actually, IR spectra is the plot of percentage transmittance versus the frequency in the wave number or centimeter minus 1, that is given by nu bar. As we have said earlier, nu bar is equal to 1 upon lambda. It means it is the reciprocal of the wavelength. And what is transmittance? Actually, transmittance is the ratio of IT upon IO. What is IT? IT is the intensity of the transmittance, transmitted light, and it is the intensity of the actual light or that passes through the molecule, original light. So it is the ratio of these two. It means how much light is transmitted through the molecule. So in this spectra, we plot the percentage transmittance against the wave number. And as a result of this, we get several dips in this spectra. In this, we does not get peaks. The peaks are in the form of dip. Why it is? Because the molecule is absorbing the IR radiations. and we are plotting the transmittance. And transmittance is given by the log. It means A is equal to log tan 1 upon T. So, as the absorbance increases, the transmittance decreases. It means when there is any functional group present in the molecule. Suppose here a functional group is present and it absorbs at this frequency. Then here the molecule will absorb the IR radiation and the transmittance decreases here. So we get a dip at this point because here transmittance is decreasing and absorbance is increasing. So we get a dip at this point. And here also, as the frequency increases, another functional group will absorb at this particular frequency. And here the absorbance is something less. So the transmittance is more and we get a little peak here. In this way, we get several dips in the IR spectra of the molecule according to the different functional groups. Now the point is, what is the use of the IR spectroscopy? Actually, IR spectroscopy is very useful for the identification of various functional groups present in the molecule because every functional group gives a peak at a definite frequency. However, it changes with the environment of the molecule or the presence of the another functional group in the molecule. But they have a specific position. For example, if we see the alkanes, the carbon-carbon stretching frequency for the alkanes is near 1000 to 1200 centimeter minus 1, while the CH stretching frequency for it is near 2900 centimeter minus 1. If we see alkenes, for alkenes there is a double bond present, and we should know that as the bond increases, it means as the strength increases, the frequency also increases. So here the carbon-carbon stretching frequency is near 1600 to 1660 centimeter minus 1. Here one thing is to be noted that in the case of terminal alkenes, there are two hydrogen bonds. It means this CH stretch frequency is also seen in the case of terminal alkenes, and that is near the 3000 to 3100 centimeter minus 1. So if we see any peak near this, we should possibly found that there is a terminal alkene present in that molecule. In the case of alkynes, there is triple bond present. So the frequency will increase more than the alkenes. Here the C triple bond C stretching frequency will be around 2100 to 2200 centimeter minus 1. While in the case of terminal alkynes, when the triple bond is present at the terminal position, there will be one important peak for this CH stretching. That is near the 3100 to 3300 centimeter minus 1. So if you see this peak, this will be definitely for the terminal alkynes. And one thing also should be noted that the symmetrical alkenes does not give any IR absorption peak because they are IR inactive because there is no change in their dipole movement. Now the another important group is the carbonyl group. That is C double bond O group. When we pass the IR radiation through it, it becomes slightly plural. It means the carbon has a slightly positive charge while the oxygen will have a slightly negative charge. So there will be change in a dipole moment and hence it is IR active. Actually it absorbs near 1700 centimeter minus 1. But there is a slight change in its position according to the presence of different groups or different derivatives. Let's we see this in the case of aliphatic aldehydes, that is RCHO. In this compound, the IR absorption is at 1700 centimeter minus 1. While in aliphatic ketones, that are RRC double bond O. It absorbs somewhat less than the aldehydes and near 1680 to 1700. But how we will identify between them? Because in the case of aldehydes, there is a hydrogen present. So in this case, we get a CH stretch near 2700 to 2800 centimeter minus 1. If we see the amides, in this case, there is an amino group present and the nitrogen here in the amino group, it is electron donating group. So in this case, the CO stretching frequency is somewhat decreased due to presence of the electron donating group. So it is near 1630 to 1690 centimeter minus 1. If we see the IR spectra of any ester, in this it means RC double bond O OR. Here a OR group is present and it is electron withdrawing in character. So it will increase the CO stretching frequency somewhat. It means the CO stretching frequency will be somewhat above 1700, that is 1720 to 1750 centimeter minus 1. While in the case of anhydride, here we get two peaks. Why? Because there are two carbonyl groups present and both will absorb. So we get two peaks here, one at 1740 to 1790 and another peak at 1800 to 1850 centimeter minus 1. While in the case of acid chloride, if we see the spectra of RCOCl, here you can see there is a chlorine atom and chlorine is highly electronegative. It means highly electron withdrawing character is here. So it will absorb at a highly increased frequency, that is from 1700 to almost 1815 centimeter minus 1. So from this we can conclude that if there is any electron withdrawing group present, it will increase the stretching frequency, and if there is any electron donating group present, it will decrease the frequency. Now if we see the spectra of any ester or ether, how we will differentiate between these two? In this case, ester, there is a carbonyl group present with this OCH3 attached to this carbonyl group. While in the case of ether, there is an oxygen and the two groups, two R groups are attached to this oxygen. It means two carbons are attached by single bond to this oxygen. As we have said earlier, in the case of ester, we get the peak at 1720 to 1750 centimeter minus 1, that is the identical of the carbonyl group. While in the case of ether, we get a C single bond O stretching frequency near 1000 to 1150 centimeter minus 1. So we can easily identify between the ester and the ether. Now if we look at the spectra of a compound that possesses a carboxylic acid group, it means when a group COOH is present in a compound, in this there is a carbonyl group and a OH group. So we will get a C double bond O stretching frequency near 1700 centimeter minus 1, that is for the carbonyl compounds. And we also get a OH stretching frequency near 2500 to 3300 centimeter minus 1. So we can easily identify the carboxylic group. And if there is an alcoholic group, it means OH group is present. In this case, we get the OH stretching frequency near 3200 to 3500 centimeter minus 1. But in the case of primary alcohols, in this case the carbon is in the sp3 hybridized state. So we get a peak near 1000 to 1150 centimeter minus 1, and this is the identical of the primary alcohols, and we can easily identify them with this peak. In the case of amines, where NH2 group is present, in this case we will get the NH stretching frequency. In the case of primary amines, when there are two NH bonds, so we will get two signals like this. These for the two NH stretching frequencies near 3300 to 3500 centimeter minus 1. While in the case of secondary amines, where there is only one NH bond, in this case we will get only one signal like this. That will be for the one NH stretching, and this will be near 3300 to 3500 centimeter minus 1. So in the primary amine we get two signals, while in the secondary amine we get only one signal. And if we look at the nitro compounds, it means when NO2 group is present, here there are two NO bonds present, so we will get two signals for the NO stretching near 1380 centimeter minus 1, while there will be one signal at 1550 to 1600 centimeter minus 1. Now in the case of aromatic compounds, this will possess this type of structure. It will possess the benzene ring, and hence it will show a C double bond C stretching frequency near 1600 centimeter minus 1, and it also show a CH stretching frequency near 3100 centimeter minus 1. Besides this, this also possesses one band for the C double bond C stretch near 1475 to 1500 centimeter minus 1. Here one thing should be noted, that as the conjugation increases, the frequency decreases. It means with increasing the conjugation, the frequency is decreasing. If we consider these examples, we can see that in this compound there is only one double bond, and it show a peak at 1650 centimeter minus 1. While in this compound there are two double bonds, and that are in the conjugation, so it possesses the peak at 1620. In this compound there are three bonds and all are in the conjugation, so it shows a peak at 1600 centimeter minus 1. Now in this compound we can also see that this is the cyclohexanal. Here there is no double bond, no conjugation, so this compound shows the IR spectra at 1730 centimeter minus 1. It shows a peak. While in this compound, this is benzaldehyde, in this there are three double bonds in the conjugation, so the frequency decreases and it shows at 1700 centimeter minus 1. While in the case of salicylaldehyde, there is conjugation, and beside this there is also a hydrogen bonding. So this also decreases the vibrational frequency, and it absorbs at 1666 centimeter minus 1. So by these we can easily detect any functional group present in the molecule with the help of the IR spectroscopy. In our next video we will study about the other type of spectroscopy. If you like this video, please subscribe and keep on watching. Till then, thank you.